Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and share. In today's video, I am going to show you how I make these marranitos, porquitos, however you want to call it. They are delicious. Look how good they look. And it takes really no time at all. And you could do it by hand, you could do it on your stand mixer. Really, it doesn't matter. I did it on the stand mixer, which I'm going to show you, and it was easier for me. But you do it however you want. Now, let's get started. Now to begin with, this recipe takes molasses, but you can make your own molasses. And what I'm going to be doing here is making my own. So I am using one piloncillo, 1/4 cup of water, 1/4 cup of brown sugar, and 2 tablespoons of vanilla. Put everything in the pot, and I'm pretty much just going to cook it down. It takes about 15 minutes for this. So once all that piloncillo is cooked down and everything, you should get this right here. And this is a substitute for molasses, but of course you can use molasses. So we're going to set that aside and get started with the rest. The ingredients I will have down on the description, but here I'm adding the flour, the cinnamon, the allspice, baking powder, baking soda, and salt. So we're going to do the dry ingredients first, and I'm just going to mix this up with my paddle attachment, but you can use a whisk, whatever. And after all that's done, I am going to be adding in the brown sugar. And I'm going to mix that into this flour mixture really good. And now we're going to get ready to throw in our wet ingredients. So here I have canola oil, you can use butter. And I'm throwing in my piloncillo mixture. Make sure to get all that in there. And here I'm throwing in the milk, the eggs, the vanilla. And you're going to want to use your paddle attachment for this. You can do this by hand, okay? But I was being lazy today, and this was the quickest for me. Use your hands if you want to, go ahead, but I'm using my stand mixer. So I'm getting all this mixed, and once it looks like this, I'm going to scrape it, and I'm going to flour my surface, and I'm going to dump this all out. Now this dough can be pretty sticky. As you can see here, I had trouble taking it out of this this thing here. And well, I needed enough flour, so I'm going to just use enough flour to just knead it a little bit by hand. I probably kneaded it maybe about 5 minutes. And once it looks like this, all nice and smooth, I'm just gonna set this to the side. And once again, flour my surface. Now this time, I am going to really add some flour on here. You want to really make sure it's floured, because once you roll this dough out, it could stick to the bottom and you're gonna have troubles when you are punching out your piggies here. So I'm gonna roll this out, and you know, you can roll this out as thick or as thin as you want. If you want them thinner, they're gonna just come out a little bit more, you know, harder, crispier. But if you roll it out thicker, you're going to have some very soft marranitos. We like it on the thicker side, so that's what I'm going to do. And here I have my marranito. I'm going to flour that because it also does help. And I'm just going to punch out the cookies here. I did have some kind of trouble when I was taking it out right there on the little tail. I don't know how that was, but it just kept getting stuck to the cookie cutter. Anyway, it came out, and then I'm going to place this on a baking sheet lined with parchment paper. By now, you should have your oven preheated at 350 degrees. And here you go, it got stuck again. But I got it. And then just continuing on until I'm done with this dough here. And then I'm going to just bring that right back up together, and I'm going to knead this, roll it out again, and do the same thing. So you're gonna wanna do that until you finish the dough. My cookie cutter isn't like a large one. It's kind of like a, not a real small one either. It's, I would say, medium-sized one. So I did get a lot of cookies out of this. If you have a larger cookie cutter, I mean, you're still gonna get a lot of cookies. It's just gonna be less. And of course, if you have a tinier cookie cutter, well, you're gonna get a whole lot more. But so it just, you know, depends. But this recipe is, it's pretty good. I love this recipe. I use it all the time. So I'm just gonna continue to punch these out. And I went a bit further, and with the, like a, that's like a coffee straw, I'm gonna punch out eyeballs just so the little piggy can have little eyes. I think that would be cute, like for the kids. They'd be like, oh, the piggy has a little eye. But you know, you can leave it the way it is if you want. And now once this is done, I am going to do an egg wash before it goes into the oven. So I'm doing one egg. I'm just gonna do the egg, but you can add milk or water to this if you like. But I'm just going to do one egg, whisk that well, and then I'm going to be brushing these little marranitos with this egg mixture. So you do want to do an egg mixture on these marranitos, okay? The egg wash really helps them like get color. And they're going into the oven, 350 degrees for about 8 to 10 minutes. Your oven may vary, okay? And once they're out, make sure that you cool it completely. And here's my marranitos. And when you break it, see how soft that is? That is just amazing, so delicious.
And now, let's try it. You got really good. With some champurado, some coffee, some hot chocolate, these would be perfect. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my video, and we'll see you next time. Bye.